Assalamu alaikum. I am Dr. Bulbul Hossain Shuvo, Assistant Professor, Department of Community Medicine in Bashundhara Ad-din Medical College. Today, I am going to be delivered a presentation on tetanus. What is tetanus? Tetanus is an acquired disease caused by exotoxin of Clostridium tetani, clinically characterized by muscular rigidity, which will be painful paroxysmal spasm of voluntary muscle. Epidemiological feature of tetanus. Agent: Clostridium tetani is a gram-positive anaerobic spore-bearing organism. Reservoir of infection: the natural habitat of organism is soil and dust. The bacilli can be found in intestine of herbivorous animal like cattle, horse, goats, sheep, and are excreted their feces. Exotoxin: the tetanus bacilli produce a soluble exotoxin. It has that type of lethal toxicity excreted by botulinum toxin. Period of communicability: none. Not transmitted by person to person. Host factor: is commonly tetanus is a disease of active age. Basically, it will be 5 to 14 years. 6. Although higher incidence is found in male, females are also exposed due to risk of tetanus, especially during delivery or abortion leading puerperal tetanus. Occupation: agriculture workers are special risk of tetanus because their contact with soil. Rural and urban difference: the incidence of tetanus is much lower in urban than in rural areas. Environmental factor: unhygienic customs and habits, unhygienic delivery practice, using unsterile instrument for cutting the umbilical cords, ignorance of infection and lack of primary health care services. Mode of transmission: the infection is acquired by contamination of wounds with tetanus spore. Incubation period: usually 6 to 10 days. Reservoir: infected animal's intestine. Source of infection: soil, dust, earth, human and animal excreta. Cardinal feature of tetanus. Basically, tetanus has three cardinal features, that is trismus, opisthotonus and rhesus sardonicus. What is trismus? The most frequent presentation symptom of tetanus is trismus, that is painful masseter muscle, which will be lockjaw. Then, when the jaw remains tightly clenched together with spasm of facial muscle, that will be presentation is known as rhesus sardonicus. And another presentation is opisthotonus. Here we are showing a picture of opisthotonus by Sir Charles Bell, 1889. Contacted body of a soldier suffering from tetanus, and this is the picture of rhesus sardonicus. Treatment: wound management. Wound should be cleaned, removal of foreign bodies and necrotic tissue. Human tetanus immunoglobulin 5000 units IM as soon as possible, and then tetanus toxoid. Here we can also use antibiotic penicillin 20 million unit IV for 7 to 10 days to all patients. Ceftriaxone and metronidazole also can be used. Spasm can be controlled by giving ceftriaxone and diazepam. Patient should be kept in a quiet and dark room. Respiratory care, maintenance of hydration and nutrition. Prevention: active immunization, 3 dose of pentavalent vaccine, 6, 10 and 14 weeks of age to prevent neonatal tetanus, all women of childbearing age need to be immunized with 5 doses of monovalent vaccine and tetanus toxoid. TT schedule for reproductive women. Here has 5 schedule for reproductive women. First schedule, it can be given as reproductive age as soon as possible, that is 15 to 49 years. Second dose, 1 month later. Third dose, 6 months later. Fourth dose, at least 1 year later. And dose number 5, at least 1 year later. Passive immunization, human, for human, it will be tetanus immunoglobulin, 250 international unit for all age, no serum reaction here, protection given for 30 days or more. And risk of tetanus reaction should be precautionate. Prevention of tetanus neonatorum. Here we have used all type of clean, here clean delivery practice, clean hand, clean surface, clean cord, clean blade, clean tie, clean umbilical stuff. Active immunization of mother for reproductive age, for unimmunized pregnant, here we can use 2 dose of tetanus toxoid. It can be given as 20 weeks to 24 to 28 weeks. For immunized beyond 5 years, 1 booster dose of tetanus toxoid. For age 15 to 49 years, full courses of tetanus toxoid. Prevention of tetanus after injury. Here has 4 categories of immunity. Category A, tetanus toxoid complete, dose complete and booster dose given within 5 years. Category B, tetanus toxoid course complete or booster dose given more than 5 years but less than 10 years. Category C, tetanus toxoid dose complete or booster dose given more than 10 years. And category D, tetanus toxoid not completely given or unknown status. What we will be if this is fresh case, clean, superficial and minor injuries, category A, we have to do nothing. Category B, toxoid for 1 dose. Category C, toxoid for 1 dose. And category D, full dose of tetanus toxoid. Old, dirty and deep minor injury, we should be category A, nothing. Category B, toxoid and tetanus toxoid 1 dose. Category C, tetanus toxoid 1 dose and given with tetanus immunoglobulin. Category D, toxoid full course with tetanus immunoglobulin. Now, I am going to be finished my today's topics. I will come with another new topics next time. Thank you.